Hello friends, I am Krishna Kanjani from LG Institute of Engineering and Technology. Welcome to the online lecture series on Kinematics and Theory of Motion. In this session, we will learn about velocity and acceleration analysis in K-top. This session will cover up about basic introduction and method of instantaneous center method, which is used to solve numericals of velocity analysis. So let's start this session with basic introduction. So let's consider one link AB which is initially at position like this. Now we are applying some input force so that it will be moving to another position. Let's consider that after some time it is obtaining its another position, which is somewhat like this, that is point A dash and point B dash. So over here we can observe that from position 1 to position 2 it is moving with combination of two type of motion. First motion that we can consider as a translatory motion, or we can say simply a horizontal movement motion. So link AB is translating in one direction. Now in second condition we can assume that now this link is rotating about point A and reaching to point B dash. So in this way we can say that position 1 to position 2 is obtained by combination of two motion, that is translation and rotation. Now it is not necessary that first translation will occur and then rotation will occur. It may be possible that initially it will rotate first, that it is rotating in such a way like this, that point B is first rotating and reaching to point B dash position, and then it is translating. So in these both the cases we have to observe only its final position. We are not concentrating on intermediate positions where it is rotation first or translation first. Okay, so we are just considering two positions, initial position 1 and final position 2. Now to reach from point 1 to 2 it has done two type of motion, translation and rotation. Now we can assume that it is only a one type of motion, that is rotation. Now how it can occur? So let's consider that point A and A dash is joined by this green line. Now if we plot perpendicular line to this joining line A dash, then it will be somewhat like this. Now similarly we can sketch perpendicular line which is joining to point B to B dash. Okay, so let's join point B to B dash. Now if we sketch perpendicular line of B to B dash, then it will be like this. So in this way the intersection of these two perpendicular line will give us one point which can be considered as a center of this rotation. So now if we assume that about this I point, we can say that link AB is rotating, because over here if you consider I as a center, then you can sketch, or with the help of rounder you can obtain that point A to A dash will be like this and point B to B dash will be like this. So in this way with respect to this I point, we can say that link AB is completely in rotation, or in other word we can say that for this position point I is an instantaneous center, or we can say for this instant it is instantaneous center for point for this link AB. Now how it will be? Somewhat like this. So if you consider AB as position 1 and A1 B1 as your position 2, then again we can solve we can join these lines in this figure. You can observe that point A to A1 if you sketch perpendicular about point M, similarly B to B1 perpendicular about point N, then you will get point I, which is for this instant we can say, or we can say for link AB at this instant point I will be its center about which the whole link AB is rotating. Okay, so this is the basic fundamental that combined motion of rotation and translation of link may be assumed to be a pure rotation, and this center is known as instantaneous center of rotation. Okay, now for any instant we can find instantaneous center for a body, or we can say that instantaneous center of a moving body may be simply defined as that center which goes on changing from one instant to another instant. Okay, similarly, if you consider that after some time, the point A1 and B1 is again making another motion or another position, that is A2 and B2. So now for this A2 and B2 position, if you consider, then you can sketch this, you can join these two lines and they're perpendicular. If you sketch their perpendicular, then it will make combination and you will get instantaneous center about this point. So in this way, you can sketch various instantaneous center for various instants, or we can say for various positions. And this is how we can consider any motion into a simply pure rotating motion. Okay, so this fundamental will be useful in solving velocity numericals. Okay, so now in this diagram, if we consider that velocity of point A is VA and similarly velocity of point B is VB, then we can say that VA upon VB is equal to radius, that is AI upon BI. Okay, or we have a simple equation, that is relation with the linear and angular velocity. We have relation V is equal to R into omega. Okay, now we can say that V1 is equal to R1 into omega 1. Okay, now for this instant, link AB will be rotating with angular velocity omega. So over here, omega will remain constant. So we can say V1 is equal to R1 omega. Or we can say VA is equal to RA into omega. Or we can say VB is equal to RB into omega. Okay, now in this instant, in both the cases, omega will remain constant. So we can say, if you consider omega as a constant and if you equate the equation, so we can say omega is equal to VA upon RA. And what is RA? That is radius of point A. So radius of point A is, that is AI, this distance. Okay, similarly, what will be the radius of B? That is BI. So we can say omega is equal to VA upon RA, or we can say is equal to VB upon RB. So in this way, we can find angular velocity of any link by taking ratio of their velocity and their radiuses. Okay, so this fundamental will help us in solving the numericals. Now, second fundamental, that is number of instantaneous center for any mechanism. So it is depending upon number of link. If we consider n number of link, then for that mechanism, we can say capital N, that is number of instantaneous centers, is equal to small n into n minus 1. Okay, so in this way, we can calculate that capital N, that is number of instantaneous centers, is equal to small n, that is number of link, in n into n minus 1 by 2. Okay, so this equation is very essential and very useful for our numericals. Now, second fundamental, that is types of instantaneous center. Okay, so there are mainly three types of instantaneous center: fixed one, permanent, and neither fixed nor permanent instantaneous center. Let's consider one example. Let's consider a 4-bar link mechanism, 4-bar chain mechanism. So let's consider this one is your link number 1, which is connected with link number 2, connected with link number 3, and your final link number 4. Okay, so now in this condition, if you consider this 4-bar chain mechanism, so in this system, if you want to calculate number of instantaneous center, then we have relation, that is capital N is equal to small n into n minus 1 by 2. So over here, n, that is number of link, we have 4 number of links, so we will put 4 into 4 minus 1 by 2, so that will give us 6. So we can say that in this mechanism, we will have 6 instantaneous center that we have to locate. Okay, now where it will be located? So we can locate link number 1 and link number 2's instantaneous center by I12. Okay, if we want to locate instantaneous center for the two links, that is link number 1 and link number 2, then we have to use this notation I12. Okay, so now over here we will observe that over here we will get one instantaneous center, that is I12. Similarly, we can locate various instantaneous centers and they can be sketched like this. So if we consider link number 1, 2, 3 and 4, then we will have various instantaneous centers I12, I14, I24 and I13. Okay, so these six are the instantaneous center of this four power chain mechanism. Okay, now in this system we have to just first we are learning types of instantaneous center. So first, that is I14 and I12. These two instantaneous centers are termed as a fixed instantaneous center. Fixed means they will not change in any circumstances. If you are applying any rotation to your link number 2 or link number 4, then hold the all the other links, link number 2, 3 and 4 will move, but I14 and 12 will remain at their positions. That's why they are termed as a fixed instantaneous center. Okay, now second one, that is I34, this two instantaneous center, that is I34 and I23. So now in this case I34 and I23, they both will be moving with respect to this motion. If you apply input motion to link number 2, or we can say link number 2 is rotating, so with that link number 2, I23 will be also moving, because it is connecting link number 2 and 3. It is located at the pin joint of this second and third link. Similarly, the I34 point is located at the pin joint of link number 3 and link number 4. So over here we can say that link number, this I23 and 34, both will be moving with the rotation, but they will not change their position. Okay, they will remain at their joint point only. Okay, so that's why they both are known as a permanent instantaneous center. They will always permanently mounted at the pin joint, but they are not fixed. They can move. Okay, so in that case, first two, that is 12 and 14, are known as a fixed instantaneous center because they will not change their position. But I23 and 34 will change their position, but they will remain at the joint point. That's why they are termed as a permanent instantaneous center. So the third one, that is the remaining two, I24 and I13. Okay, if you observe this figure, then over here I24 and I13. So over here, these two instantaneous centers, they are located by graphical method. They are obtained by joining these dashed lines. Okay, so so by simple observation we can say that they will move as we will change the positions. Okay, so they are considered as a neither fixed nor permanent instantaneous center. They will continuously change their position. Okay, so in this way we can classify the instantaneous centers in mainly three categories: fixed instantaneous center, permanent instantaneous center, and neither fixed nor permanent instantaneous centers. Okay, next fundamental, how we can locate instantaneous centers. Okay, so instantaneous centers can be located by various consideration. Let's consider one pin joint, that is a crank connection system. So let's consider this one is your link number 1 and link number 2. These both the links are connected with this pin joint. Okay, so now we can consider that with respect to link number 1, link number 2 is rotating, then their center will be I12, or we can say at their pin joint. Or if you consider with respect to link number 2, link 1 is moving, then in that case again also we can consider that I12 or their pin joint at their center. Okay, so first condition, that when two links are connected by pin joint, we have to learn this fundamental very clearly so that we can use in numericals. Okay, so when two links are connected by pin joint, then the instantaneous center will lie at the center of their pin. Okay, now second condition, if they are moving, or we can say they are rolling. Okay, let's consider one example, that this sphere is rolling on this flat surface. Okay, so while the sphere is rotating, we can consider various point on this sphere. Let's consider point B and point A. Okay, so they are moving with this in their perpendicular direction, perpendicular line of joint, which is making contact with this fixed point. Okay, so over here you can refer that with respect to this contact point, the point B is moving in this direction. Similarly, with respect to point A, well, we can consider that velocity of point A is in this direction. Okay, so now in this case, their center can be considered as their contact point. Okay, over here, if you observe that with respect to this flat surface, this sphere is rolling. But if you consider, if you want to consider the center point, then the center point will be at their contact point. Okay, if you will consider another position like this, so in this condition, your contact point will make the direction for the velocity of various points. Okay, so over here, we will not consider the center of your rolling body, but we have to consider the contact point of this rolling body, because with respect to this contact point, this body is continuously rolling, or we can say that continuously rotating. Okay, so second fundamental, that when two links are having pure rolling contact between them, their instantaneous center will lie on their point of contact. Okay, now third fundamental, let's consider the sliding motion. Okay, so first condition, let's consider that a slider is moving on this flat horizontal surface. Okay, so now in this case, we will consider that this velocity of this slider will be in the line of motion direction, or we will simply say that it is in horizontal direction. Okay, so now with respect to this link one, that is fixed surface, your slider, okay, over here, if you consider that with respect to your link number one, that is your fixation, your slider is moving in horizontal direction. Okay, so over here, what will be the center point? So over here, your motion is purely horizontal motion. So if you want to consider that it is in a rotary motion, that so in that case, the center will remain at the perpendicular direction. Okay, so over here, if you sketch perpendicular, or we can say normal to their velocity, then it will be in a vertical direction like this. Okay, so now this vertical motion will be at infinite length. It can be at infinite length. Okay, so over here, we will simply say, or we can simply say that if a body is simply moving in horizontal direction, then in that case, if you want to consider its rotary motion, then their center will be at infinite direction. Okay, with respect to their infinite vertical direction, we can consider that this body is rotating, but otherwise it can be considered as a purely horizontal motion. Okay, now it will occur if the body, if the contact surface is flat, but if the contact surface is rotating, it is in curvature shape. If the contact surface is in curvature shape, so now your body motion will occur like this in a rotary motion, and this rotary motion is with respect to this center of this curvature. So we can say that in that case, the instantaneous center will be obtained by sketching perpendicular of these two points, and that will give us the center point of this motion. Okay, similarly, if we consider concave and convex, two different cases, but their centers will be remaining at the center of that curved surface. Okay, so simply we can say that when the two links having sliding contact between them, the instantaneous center will lie on the common normal at a point of contact. Okay, so if you will sketch common normal of these two points, so they both are moving, they are approaching towards infinite direction in first case. So that's why over here I want to add infinite. But in concave and convex surfaces, we can consider that these two normals will intersect at their center points. So that's why we will get I12 point at the center of this curvature. Okay, so in this way, we can locate instantaneous center of various mechanisms. So this fundamental will help us in solving the numericals. Okay, so in next session, we will learn how to locate this instantaneous center in our particular given mechanism, and then we will solve some numericals. Okay, thank you.